Hello, this is Emily, and I'd like to welcome you to this unit edit video. What type of journal should I target? Knowing what type of journal to target is important to finding the right fit for your paper topic and research style. Therefore, testing whether your research meets these criteria is a good way to self-assess your research and decide which journal is most suitable for your work. Targeting a suitable journal for your research increases the probability your paper is read by the right audience in your field, which helps advance your own profile and knowledge in your field by reaching a demographic that is more likely to cite and disseminate your research. Irrespective of the soundness and novelty of your research, reaching your target audience depends largely on readership accessibility options in the journal. Selecting the appropriate level of accessibility for your paper may seem straightforward, but it is generally constrained by whether the journal or publisher offers these options and journal fees. Journals are generally categorized as either paid subscription or open access regarding their readership accessibility. Paid subscription is a membership service to the journal, usually covered by the university or research institution, that allows readers to access the journal's content via institutional login access. Journals will usually only publish material from paid subscribers. Therefore, as an author, you will need paid subscription via your institution, but this largely depends on the type and outreach of the journal. For your audience, your paper is primarily read within the academic community with paid access to journal content. Conversely, open access papers are disseminated more widely due to no subscription restrictions for readers. This means papers are publicly available. However, allowing open access does not come without fees. Journals, as publishers, need to pay publishing, administration, and intellectual property and copyright overheads, the costs of running a journal, to open their papers freely to the public. The level of accessibility for your paper depends on you as an author or author's institution paying the open access fee. This fee, covered by either the individual author or the institution, covers the publishing overheads to allow the journal paper to be freely available to the public without the need for subscription to the journal. A quick recap of the differences and the similarities between open access and paid subscription. Across the top, you can see that both open access and paid subscription either can serve to reach your target audience. On the left, open access. While no paid subscription is required, there are typically fees. On the right, paid subscription. Journals only publish from paid subscribers. On the left, open access. Audience is usually more publicly available. On the right, paid subscription. Audience can be limited to paid subscribers of the journal. Some offer open access options. Within the life sciences, more and more journals are becoming open access. Open access journals are increasingly seen as the modern journal, as they provide publicly available content, overcome financial barriers for readers that would normally require a financial commitment to access content, and reach a larger readership due to improvised accessibility. Here's a digital list of open access journals as published by Elsevier. If you scroll down, you can see that published articles on these are fully peer-reviewed. They are immediately free to access and download from ScienceDirect. They're permitted reuse defined by the author's choice of the Creative Commons user licenses. and they're published with crossmark to maintain the publication record. Notice open access publication fee. A fee is payable by the author or their institution or funder to cover the publication costs. Fees can range from $150 to $5,000 US, excluding tax. Visit your journal's homepages for specific pricing information. So this is an A to Z directory of open access journals. And as you can see, by clicking upon one of them, I would be able to receive more information. Since they are alphabetized, I am now into the B section, but as I continue to scroll, this is an extremely long list of open access journals. We hope you enjoyed this tip. Once again, this is Emily from UniEdit. Have a wonderful day.